In this video, you will see what is Google search optimization based on Gauss distribution. Before we tried this algorithm via Lavis flight, right now we are doing this via Gauss distribution. You can see here in this video what is Google search algorithm all about is explained here, and this is the example of this algorithm. And right now in this video I will discuss this algorithm using an example. So what is Google search, you can see in this video. So right now we will do what is Google search optimization based on Gauss distribution. Topics that are covered in this video: what is Google search optimization algorithm and how we can do this using Gauss distribution, how we can update the position of the each cuckoo using Gauss distribution. Then we will explain this algorithm step by step using numerical example how this algorithm is working. So first of all, what is cuckoo search? As we all know, this is a meta heuristic algorithm and it is inspired by some species of cuckoos and you know their behavior of laying their egg in the nest of other species bird. And as they are laying the egg in the nest of other species, it increased their population and their survival. Right now in this algorithm, we have two words, that is cuckoo bird and host bird. We are denoting other species bird by host bird. And you know the behavior of cuckoo bird laying its egg in the nest of host bird. As the cuckoo bird is laying its egg in the nest of host bird, so there is a probability of discovery of cuckoo's egg by the host bird. In case if host bird discovered cuckoo's egg, it can either throw away the egg or it can build completely new nest. According to some research work, there is only 10% possibility of discovery of cuckoo's egg by host bird. Right now we will denote this by P alpha. This is the probability of discovery of cuckoo's egg by the host bird, and we will take the value in the range in between 0 to 1, that is exact value we will take for this is 0.25, that is suitable for most of the problems. Next, you can see we have three rules for implementation of this algorithm and also for the simplicity. So according to first rule, each cuckoo can lay only one egg at a time and it can place it in a randomly selected nest. And second rule is best nest with high quality of egg carry over to the next generation, and the number of host nests is fixed, and you know the probability of discovery of cuckoo's egg by the host bird, and it can build new nest or it can throw away the egg. So this is cuckoo search based on Gauss distribution. Starting with objective function, we will calculate the objective function and the fitness value for each cuckoo for the initial population. And you can see we have to initialize the population of n host nest. After that we will check this condition. If condition is true, then we will select a cuckoo randomly by Gauss distribution, then we will calculate its fitness value. After that we will select a nest among n randomly. You can select any nest. Then we will compare the fitness value of the randomly selected cuckoo, or you can say the nest, with the randomly selected nest. Here we will compare these two values that we recently calculated and that we randomly selected. If the fitness value of this new solution that we generated is better, then we will replace the randomly selected nest by new solution. Then we will check its probability of discovery of the cuckoo's egg. After that we will rank the solution and find the current best. This is cuckoo search based on Gauss distribution, and this is cuckoo search by Lavis flight. You know there is only one difference between these two algorithms. Here we are doing, here in this step you can see get the cuckoo randomly by Lavis flight, and here we are doing get the cuckoo randomly by Gauss distribution. All the steps are same, only there is a difference in one step, that is we are selecting here by Gauss distribution and here Lavis flight. Now first step is we will initialize the population. We will take 5 number of host nest for this example, and you know the rule for population is size should be 50 to 20 times the number of design variables. For the initialization of population we need some parameters, and population size lower bound in the upper bound. This is the source code for the initialization of cuckoo's population. You can see here, initialize the number of host nest and total number of parameters, maximum number of iteration, or you can say generation, lower bound and upper bound. After that, this is for the population initialization. This is the output of the source code. So this is the initial population that is for cuckoo search. Now we will work on this. So you know, there is no difference between nest, cuckoo, egg. So you can say either nest, or you can say cuckoo, or you can say egg. There is no difference, right? Second step is we will calculate the fitness value for each cuckoo. You can see here, now we will calculate the fitness value of the each cuckoo using this objective function, and we will denote these values for x1 and these values for x2. Put the value of the each cuckoo here in this objective function and calculate its fitness value. You can see here I calculated the fitness value for each cuckoo in this slide. You can see now next step is, so this is the final values that we calculated for each cuckoo. Now next step is initialize the worst case parameter, that is the probability of discovery of cuckoo's egg. We will consider the value 0.25, that is in the range 0 to 1, and this is the maximum number of iteration you can take. So you know, the aim of this algorithm is we will replace better or the new solution with bad solution, that is in the current population. Cuckoo search is nothing, we're just a searching process where a bird, that is cuckoo, is searching for a suitable nest for laying its egg. So according to this, now we are here. Now we will select a cuckoo randomly by Gauss distribution. Gauss distribution is performed by this equation, and in the research paper they use this equation to perform Gauss distribution. You can see here we will select a cuckoo randomly. So I'm selecting here first cuckoo, so the value of I is 1. So this equation is used to perform Gauss distribution, and you know, this is the step size. So keep in mind, proper step size is important for the search space. If the step size is too large, it means new solution generated will be too far away from the older one. If the step size that we calculated is smaller, then change in position will be too small. So it is important to keep in mind to make the proper step size for the each cuckoo. Now you can see here, this is T, that is the current generation, or you can say iteration, and this is constant value, and the value we will use for these two is 1/2, and this is minus 0.0001. Now you can see here, this is the final, you know, the sigma s is calculated by this equation. So this is now we are performing for first randomly cuckoo, we are updating a new solution. So you can see here this equation. So let's see what is this. This is the new solution that we are generating for new randomly selected cuckoo, and this is the current position or the location of the randomly selected cuckoo, and this is the step size. We will take the value of this step size 1, and this is the entry wise multiplication, that is the product operator, and this is the Gauss distribution. Done. Now calculate the value here. You can see these two are constant, so we will keep the value constant, and we calculated value for sigma s is 0.4995. You can see the fitness values here. So now we will obtain a solution for randomly selected cuckoo, and we will calculate the value for both x1 and x2. So in this equation we will put the values. So right now counter is 0, that is value of t is 0. We selected first cuckoo, value of I is 1. This is the current location of the first cuckoo. You can see the value in the x1, that is 1.5574. Step size 1. Value we calculated for sigma s is 0.45995. Then you can see here, this is for x1, this is for x2. You can see the value for x2 here, -4.6429. Done. Put the value calculated here. If you found any error, you can comment below. I'm doing this first time, I don't. So if you found any error, you can comment below. So let's see next. Now here we selected. Now we will select the nest randomly. After that, we will compare the fitness value. So before next step, you know, we will compare the fitness value. So we need to calculate the fitness value for. This is the optimization value that we calculated for the first cuckoo. Now we will compare the fitness value of this new position with the randomly selected nest. Fitness means how fit a solution is. If the fitness value that you calculated is higher, it means this is the worst case. If the value you calculated is lower, it means it is better. So we are doing here optimization, so we need minimum value. So we will do optimization, we will optimize the value. So the lower values, lower fitness values are better as compared to higher one. Now I will select the first nest. I will compare the value of the here. I randomly selected this cuckoo, or you can say nest. Now we'll compare the value. You can see this is the new solution, this is the older value. You can see the new position of the cuckoo that we generated here is better as compared to the older one. So next step is we will replace this value by new value. Done. So this is replaced. Now again we will do this for all the cuckoos. Select any cuckoo randomly. Now we will do this for the second cuckoo. Calculate the value for x1, x2, put the value, calculate the fitness value using this objective function, compare it. You can see here the value that we calculated now for the new position of this cuckoo is not better, so we will use this value. No need to replace the value now. So we will consider older one. Like that you will update the values for all cuckoo. I'm just updating for these two values. Now next step is, you can see here, now we will check the burst nest here. So we will replace the burst nest by building newer one. So in order to do this, what we will do, we will use this equation here. I'm taking a random number r1 that is generated uniformly, that is uniformly distributed random number, and we will take in the range 0 to 1. If the random number is less than the probability value, that is 0.25, then the individual is selected and modified, otherwise it remains without change. If the random number is less, then we will do modification, because here the probability of discovery of cuckoo egg is greater. It means the egg is discovered by host nest, so we need to do some modification, else remains as it is. So we will use this operation here. Here you can see we use any random number. D1, D2 are the random integer from 1 to n, and value of n is here 5, and in this way we will replace the new solution with the host nest. Value we are taking for probability is 0.25. So suppose I selected any random number, that is 0.8584. You can see here this is greater, random number is greater, so we do not need to do any change, because probability value is not greater. So keep it as it is. This is the new fitness value. Now we will take for the second cuckoo. You can see here again a random number is selected, that is 0.0501. right now in this case probability value, that is probability of discovery of cuckoo egg, is greater. So it means, so right now we need to do some modification. So how we will modify? We will use this equation for the modification. Put the value here, and you can see this is for x1 and put the value of the, this is for, we are doing this for the second cuckoo, and this is the current position. You can see the value here. This is the current position, that is 3.4913, and this is the random number selected, and you can see the value of D1, D2. For D1 I'm taking 4, for D2 is 4, and I calculated this for X1. Same we will do this for X2. After that you will calculate the fitness value. So you can see here, this is the previous calculated values and these are the new calculated values. So now we will again compare the previous calculated fitness value with the newer values. Right now in this case you can see here values are same, so no need to do any change, there is no need to do any modification, it is equal. In this case, this is the previous calculated value for the second cuckoo and this is the new fitness value that we calculated. You can see here new value is better as compared to older one, so we will use this one. You can see here we are doing optimization. Now next step is we will rank the solution, like that you will do for all these cuckoos. I'm doing for two. You can see the video, that is cuckoo search by Lewis flight. I calculated the values for all the cuckoos by Lewis flight. Here you will do this by your own. Now next step is we will rank the solution and find the current best. According to this you can see this one is the first rank and this is the second rank, that is the optimized value, that is near to the optimum value. So this is the first cuckoo. We rank the solution like this. That we will rank all the cuckoos according to their optimization value, and in the end you will get the optimum value for the each cuckoo and what is the cuckoo current best location. So after that, after doing all the steps, we will keep the best solution or the nest, that is with quality solution, and then we will rank and we will print the best solution. So that's all about cuckoo search by Gauss distribution. If you have any question, you can comment below, and I provided all the important resources related to this research work in the description box. And you know, I'm doing this by Gauss distribution first time, so if you found any error, you can comment below. And thanks for watching this video, and all the best for your research work.